Well, come in, can't you?
Howdy.
What do you want?
Some guy threw my business up in the house. I thought I'd pay you a call. You got a gun, I see.
Yeah, good one. Colt 45.
Yeah, well, what are you doing?
Shoot things.
Say, let there paint a picture. Looks like a naked woman, ain't it?
Your eyes don't lie to you.
Plump stock naked as a jaybird. No. No, she ain't. Not quite. She got some thingamabobs tied on to her.
Shit, she ain't thing to what I got here. Take a look at that top one.
I'll go blind. That gave me ideas, he would.
Yeah, it's a dinger, that is.
Sure is a dinger. That's a good-looking rope you got here, John. Sure. Ooh, short spin's nice. You know Will Parker? He can sure spin a rope. Say that. Wait. That looks like a strong beam. Judd, you could hang yourself on that.
I could what?
Hang yourself. It'd be as easy as falling off a log. Fact is, you could stand on a log or a chair if you'd rather. Right about here, see? You put this good around your neck, you tie this good up there first, of course, and then all you'd have to do would be to fall off the log. Or a chair, whichever you'd rather fall off of. Yeah. 5 minutes or less. With any luck, you'd be as dead as a doornail.
What do you mean by that?
And people come to your funeral, sing sad songs.
Yeah.
They would. You never know how many people like you till you're dead. You'd probably be laid out into the parlor with your hair all diked out. You're in your best suit, your hair slicked back in a high starch collar.
And it'd be flowers, you think?
Sure would. Palms, too, all around your coffin. Folks that stand around you, men that bend their heads, and women would sniffle softly. Some would probably faint. The ones that took a shine to you when you was alive.
Well, woman ever took a shine to me?
Oh, lots of women. Only they don't never come out right and show you how they feel. They see you die first.
I guess that's so.
They sure would sing loud, though, when the singing started. Sing like their hearts would break.
Poor John is dead. Poor John Fry is dead. All gather round his coffin now and cry. He had a heart of gold. He wasn't very old.
Folks, we are gathered here to moan and groan over our brother Judd Fry, who hung himself up by a rope in the smokehouse. Then there'd be some weeping and wailing from some of those women. And then he'd say, Judd Fry was the most misunderstood man in our territory. People used to think he was a mean, ugly fellow, used to call him a dirty skunk, and they don't repeat it up. But the folks that really know him know that between them two dirty shirts he always wore, there'd be a heart as big as all ours.
As big as all outdoors.
Judd Fry loved his fellow man.
He loved his fellow man.
He loved the birds of the forest and the beasts of the field. He loved the mice and the vermin of the barn. And he treated the rats like eagles. Which was right.
He loved all the little children. He loved everybody and everything in the whole wide world.
Only he never let on, so nobody ever knows.
Poor John is dead. Poor John Fry is dead. His friends all weep and wail for miles around.
Getting even.
Nobody that I recollect. It just came up into my head.
Yeah, well, if ever came to getting even with somebody, I'd know how to do it.
That?
Yeah. There's safer ways than that if you use your brain. You remember that fire on the Bartlett farm over by Sweetwater?
Sure do. About 5 years ago, that wasn't it? Turned up the mother, the father, and the daughter.
Yeah, well, that weren't no accident. Fella told me the hired hand was stuck on the Bartlett girl. Found her in the hayloft with another fella.
And what'd he do? Was it him? Sent him burned up the place.
Took him weeks. Get all the kerosene. Buying it up at different times. Feller told me made out like it happened in Missouri, but I know the whole time it was the Bartlett farm. What a liar he was.
I'm a murderer too, not much. Yeah, get some air here.
You know, you ain't told me what business you had here. Ain't got no cattle for sale. There are no cow ponies. Oak crops done spoke for
You sure relieved my mind considerably.
Yeah, man. Could only be one other thing on this farm you could want. You better not be there.
That's just what it is, John.
Yeah, well, you better not be. You keep away from her, you know.
You know, somebody ought to tell Laura what kind of man you are. And for that matter, somebody ought to tell you once about yourself.
Yeah. You better get out of here, Curly.
You know, people wouldn't feel very safe in you as you go.
Mm-hmm.
Unless they know you. And I know you, Judd.
Oh.
In this country, there are two things you can do if you're a man. Live out of doors is one, and live in a hole is the other. I've sat by my horse many a brush summers and hear a rattlesnake many a time. Rattle, rattle, rattle he goes, scared to death. Somebody's coming close to his horse, somebody's gonna step on him. Got his fangs all full of poison, curl up and wait. You gotta have protection, you gotta have muscles, old like iron. Even if you do, you can still be as weak as an empty bladder. How'd you get to be the way you are anyway? Sitting up here thinking the way you're thinking. Why don't you do something healthy once in a while instead of staying shut up here, a crawling and a festering? Ah! You ought to feel bad now. Awful hard on the roof, though. I wish you'd let me show you something. There's an eye hole right over there. See the winking? About as big as an eye. I just want to see if I can hit it.
What was that?
Right through the noddle. That touch of sick as a whistle, didn't I? You saw it, didn't I? Yeah. I expect somebody to come.
Who fired off a gun? Was that you, Curly? Why don't you stand there? You let me answer when you spoke to.
I shot once.
What was you shooting at?
See that knothole over there?
I see lots of knotholes.
It was one of them.
Oh. Ain't you a pair of pretty nothings? A picking away at knot holes and scaring everybody to death. I'll give you a Dutch rubbing arm some of the craziness out of you. It's all right. Nobody's hurt. Just a pair of fools swapping noises.